have an offense that keeps itself on the field. The Redskins are number one in third down percentage, and they'll be up against the Giants team looking to shut that down. With that, it's time to hook up with our top 10 to the booth.
Just inside the Beltway, about 10 miles east of the Capitol Gardens, we come to you from FedEx Field here in Landover. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New York Giants and the Washington Redskins. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. Charles, we look at this Redskin team as they interplay here. They come in on a pretty good roll here, winners of three straight. On the other side of the field for the visiting Giants, they've come in on a nice run of recent form, four wins out of five.
And the offense last week, they have things humming. If you're a defensive player, you may get overshadowed a little bit, but you're really buoyed by what your offense is doing.
Of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports. This is taken at his four. A nice move. They bring him back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. So here comes the Redskins offense now onto the field. And a glance here at the man calling the plays under center, their 6'4 quarterback.
Second down.
Solid right out of the gate. No big plays given up at all.
outside. They're playing press coverage. Second down, the ball on the two here, second and goal. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal.
And as we've seen throughout this season, it's no picnic trying to score touchdowns against this unit. They're ranked number one against the run. But it's also difficult because it's not easy to throw the ball against them either. Still left on second down.
Watch right.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And past the 30 down to about the 27. 8 yards on the run there. That leaves him with third and just a couple. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gun.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop the shoulder or get through contact or trash, it's a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line.
Well, the field goal attempt was well in hand. They had that, but they decided to go for it anyway. Extreme confidence, it looks like.
Yeah, but I bet the defense is going to remember this one, right? They kind of wet their nose on it. And nearly picked off there. Almost intercepted. Instead, second down.
Not only did they drop what looked like an interception in the end zone, they blew a golden opportunity to shift the momentum.
Free for much space, taken down right at the 10. And they get six here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a third and four.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that anytime and hand the ball to him back.
And the gun now on third down. And it'll be intercepted. Picked off with great anticipation.
can change and at least hold people to field goals. And if that keeps happening, they lose confidence in the quarterback, and then no one plays well.
Defensively, and in that 4-3, those D tackles so vital.
Extremely vital. I love how you describe that, because if they control things up front, often it's over the guard. Sometimes they slide and make it over the center.
And the giant rush gets home as down he goes.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long. The good news for them now, it's fourth down.
And this offense already feeling good about themselves with a touchdown already in their first drive. They've certainly come out firing, even though that one was incomplete.
With the 7-0 lead, more apt to take a shot like that downfield?
Hey, you're one to the good. Go ahead and try and pressure up an edge.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. First and 10 now.
Here we go.
And again, this time the tailback. And a pretty good run there as he gets 7 down to the 33. These are his numbers from last week's contest. 20 carries, 85 yards.
And they love what they've got in him. He's the number 4 rusher in the league right now. So you know that you have to account for him on defense, which means you can play complementary football as well. Throw the play action, get it out to the wide receiver, because they should have some open space, because the defense will key on it.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Went all the way down to the 9. That one goes for 24 yards.
zone beckons. It looms. They can do whatever they want. Four play back. Run it again. Or they can go play action. And that is caught.
He's got it for a giant touchdown. Robert Woods, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. There on that short slam, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. So right now come the Redskins. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position back as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense. Get a couple of first downs and hopefully flip the field.
There's something to fill that offense that they're looking for here.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And not much, maybe a yard up to the 29.
That's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Of course, the incompletion on first down, then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going at the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
To throw. And that is incomplete.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do. Hard to attain, but that's what they were searching for as that pass goes incomplete.
The Redskins send out their punter as he'll kick it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. As they take over. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
Here we go.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. He's going to fire one deep over. And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked off at the 39. What a great return as he gets this all the way down close to the 40-yard line.
Oh, that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and put in the interception.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. And it is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Isaiah Crowell with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Redskins have taken the lead. It's just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it dead on. And I just thought that was a play. And we improved the sessions right here. 9 from the receivers. And then fly route. Oh, look at that. 9. He just kept going all the way to the end zone for a touchdown.
And he'll be brought down at the 23. Make it the 24-yard line. Set to take the field. Last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some time.
See what happens. And got his man complete. And he's taken down, but not before getting this across midfield and just shy of the 40. And that one results in 35 yards. They'll look to throw now on first down. He's going to walk through on deep left side. And he's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Robert Woods with the second touchdown of the game and fifth on the year. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Fielded about a yard deep. And they're lined up about as they get set to begin another possession.
And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
Charles, they picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield for a nice completion. Bama, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. Good man, ladies and gentlemen.
And he will take it on in. Touchdown. A great play there. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
These two teams in this first half, it's been fun. Back and forth, back and forth. Well, it's not fun for the defensive coordinators, but offensive coordinators are enjoying it.
Yeah, they're having streaks here, aren't they? Being able to put scores together and really bunch them up, and we have a tight game here. You know, we often talk about having the right shoes for the right turf. Today it's track shoes. That's what we've seen with these offenses.
Yeah, it's been an absolute track meet so far, and fun to watch. And they'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. Washington as they come onto the field. Touchdowns on back-to-back drives. So a very good flow right now offensively.
Trying to slow them down, too, because they are locked in. I feel like the offense coordinator's a little bit over the defensive guys right now. They're beating them to the punch with their play calls. They've got a nice rhythm they're locked into. How can the defensive guys come up with something that'll disrupt that flow? That's what they're seeking right now.
Well, it's been an exciting sequence to watch. So 2 minutes to go in a wild first half. Back to FedEx Field following this short break. A reminder with halftime approaching, when we get there, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Larry Ridley will have first half highlights and analysis.
I hope he's ice down his throat because he's got a lot to get through, because we've had no shortage of points scored in the first half.
It has been a fun track meet. And that'll be incomplete.
That was a nice catch, but unable to stay in bounds. And remember, it wasn't a wide receiver who works on that all the time.
I was going to say, he likes to get the ball handed to him. Now, don't get me wrong, he's part of the passing game as well, but maybe a little out of his comfort zone there.
Yeah, he might want to have a few words to say to us about that later, but I am still going with you on that one. Wide receivers work on a little bit more.
The Redskins on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This time they face a 3rd and 2. They look to throw. Clock running as the Redskins try to hurry up. So they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. While we looked at each other right away, we knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because the officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Getting set to go again here, Robert Woods marches back onto the field. He's well on his way to a 1,000-yard season, maybe on pace to just tear past that, Charles. Defensively, they need to pay a little bit more attention to him.
Yeah, I think so, because remember, throwing the football, that can shred the defense quicker than anything else, because as soon as the catch is made, he still has the ability to
play. Oh, caught it up! But this will fortunately yards, maybe too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down.
Now I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule. Where the offensive player fumbles the ball, 39. Goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is where, for the offensive team, the sideline is their friend. Usually it's not there for them.
Yeah, exactly right. Actually, came for a guy who knows when he's in the sideline. Sammy sideline, and use him well. Definitely worth taking another deep shot. He has already found the end zone twice here in the first half.
Yeah, go back to that same route. They've had trouble containing him, but able to contain him on that play. Six before halftime. Well, throw it on the final play. He's going to float this one deep right. And with a clock reading zeros, he is into the end zone. What an exclamation mark to the end of this second quarter.
Indeed. Well, my education continues in this game, I've got to tell you, because there's not an analyst in the world that would have said pass up the field goal here. Go for it and expect for it to be successful, and it was. I mean, they're playing this one just like a video game.
Especially for the final play of the first half to have the guts to do that. But I guess, what do we say? The end will justify the means, right?
No doubt about it. For you and me, we live, we learn.
Defense
makes it to the 34-yard line. Staying late in the second, the quick pass and completion is made, and he counts off the seventh play drive to the score as both offenses continue to rule the game.
All right, Larry, as you just showed us, plenty of action on the scoreboard, but all tied as we get set for the second half. So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. This one fielded at the five. And a nifty return there as he's all the way up past the 40-yard line.
Well, someone went very happy about that game being tied up. They came right back at him with a big-time return. They want to get back out in front as fast as possible.
Let's go!
They'll come out throwing here on first down. From the left side, it's complete. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in his performance.
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
But no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
This time to the tailback. And this time not quite to the 30. He'll be down at the 31-yard line. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
So it'll be first down here after the run. Chunk of yardage still left here, second and seven.
Let's go, defense! Let's go, defense! Let's go! Blue 90! Blue 90!
They'll run it, man, out of the gun. And down inside the 15 he goes. They give him 14 yards that time, and a fresh set of downs.
Absolutely love the run right there. This guy's known for his quickness, but also for his speed. He's able to get to the second level almost before you blink if you give him any type of blocking. Always talk about slot receivers, and they're usually known as quicker than fast. In this case, we've got a guy who's quick and fast, and he used it to great advantage.
Well, nothing complicated about that. That's old-school power football.
and effective. And that's the key to everything, right? Sometimes we try and do too many things. Just hand it to the big guy and let him go forward.
Here's Murray for the extra point. It's up and good, and they've jumped back ahead, 35-28. So that drive goes 8 plays, and in the end, it's capped off by a 7-yard run. Now it's Murray to kick this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
I can't wait to see what they have planned. Some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things work well for us. And sometimes they're dealing with that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Together here from the D-line.
Here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
Second and goal from the one. And they turn it
take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. Rob Kelly with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Redskins are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And when the smaller guy can't power it across the goal line, Charles, sometimes you need to go with a fullback. They did. It worked.
What's that thing about it? How's that?
Yeah, force equals mass times acceleration. Teams have traded touchdowns so far with their first possessions here in the third quarter, so we're right back to where we started at intermission.
Yeah, how about that? Tied at the half, tied after the first two drives of the third quarter, one for each. That tells me that someone's defense has got to step up and make a big play and try and change the momentum of this game.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll run a man out of the gun. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. They're 5 yards on the play there. It's a drive will continue.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
On the NFL scoreboard, third quarter from Oakland. You saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. And they won't be able to run another play. Time has expired on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now at FedEx Field, all even as we get ready to start the fourth. We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on first and 10. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this out past the 45 to 47. 8 yards on the pickup, and now we'll have some options on second and short.
Well, Mark, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line bearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. Just 2 yards to go here on second down for the offense. Time running out here on the play clock.
Delay of game, offense.
That's going to set him back 5 yards.
Still second down.
7 yards to go on second down. Slow to get up after that last play. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. The Giants on third down, just 1 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 6. They can't avoid the pressure. Redskins get there. Tie game, fourth quarter, and they're going for this thing on fourth down. Boy, an incredibly aggressive move to go for it there. Game tied fourth quarter. You got to be surprised.
I am.
and I know that we're in a new era of football where we look at the analytics sometimes, and a lot of times the analytics tell you to go for it, right? But do the analytics take into account game situation, where we are, all those things? In this situation, that was an incredibly aggressive play.
And it didn't work out, and again, tie game fourth quarter makes this thing a little bit more interesting. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together.
Sometimes when you abandon the running game, it's hard to get back to it, because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people, hard to get them started again occasionally.
That is not going to be any help as they dump it behind the line of scrimmage. That'll go as a loss of five, and that's going to make it fourth down. Have to kick this field goal, don't you?
No question about it. Look at the clock. Look at the situation. Kick the field goal.
And Hopkins' kick is good. And they have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. So the drive here ends with a field goal that does give them a lead, but this one is still a long way from it.
And you'd love to be able to look up at the scoreboard and see the draft in front, but then you take one look across the field and see that offense is raring to come back out, and you think, I don't know, the field goals are going to be enough to get us home.
Here's Hopkins now out to kick it away. This one taken from the seven. He's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. And New York set to take the field. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. Good job by the defense there. They held him to three, but this offense has got to be a little bit better than the fourth quarter.
Sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
They'll look to throw here. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. Robert Woods, former USC man, the intended target. And that takes us from second to third down. I guess they're in a situation now, fourth quarter, where they're forced to take some chances, but I don't know that that was the type of a chance you want to take.
That one could very easily have been intercepted. If it does get picked up,
incomplete. The contact made the ball roll free and brings up fourth down.
A lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Back to throw. And that is incomplete. The Giants go on fourth, but can't get it. Possession here turns over with the football already being in the red zone. Back out for another drive comes LeGarrette Blount. And we have seen a decline in the numbers. Where was the fault lie? Just him? Maybe the guys up front combination?
Well, you and I both know it's almost always a collective deal. But in this case, I think maybe the offensive line got a little overconfident. They blocked so well in the first half, picked up on what the defense was doing. I think we've seen an adjustment now that they have not picked up on. And now they're being a little bit overwhelmed.
Set! Blue 90! Blue 90!
On the give, this is their throwback. And he gets it down close to the 10-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven. Leaves him with a second and three. This is where, you know, fourth quarter, you got the lead. You give it to the big guy. Defensively, kind of sucks the will out of them, doesn't it? Because they don't want to tackle him right now this late in the game.
Well, you say that with accusatory tones. I mean, you know, but you're exactly right. I know it's not something we actually want to talk about, but as a defender, four quarters worth of trying to bring people down, four quarters worth of pounding, and that late in the game, here comes that big guy coming at you, and a lot of guys are wondering whether they want to come up and make that tackle at this stage of the game.
Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down. And in this situation with a lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take. Puts a little bit more pressure on the big offensive line.
Looking to throw. His pass is into the end zone for a Washington touchdown. Well, it was third and one. I was expecting run so much for that. They pass it, they score.
That had to feel like the head coach from the offensive coordinator. You've got four downs here. We're going to go for it on fourth down unless there's a disaster. We can take a shot if we want to. And he gratefully accepted the opportunity and did exactly that. If they didn't get it there, down the field, they would come back and try to get that fourth down.
This one fielded at the five. And now return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. New York sent to take the field. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, earned him 6 points, so they've got to recover their charge.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right?
And that's caught inside the 35. A big play there for the Giants. 42 yards. On first down, they dropped a throw. Inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
Here we go.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone.
Coverage is very good that time. A nice job of smothering as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board.
A necessary first step.
Still plenty of time remaining, but you could really use a stop defensively after the kickoff, preferably a three and out.
Very short kick. This will be taken by Robbie Upmore.
That's the kind of return that warms the head of the special teams coach. They'll be pushing us next time, Brandon, to make sure his guys are introduced in the starting lineups. These guys have such an influence on every game. The unsung heroes, remember that, they have their wins, they're on practice time, got their own spot on the bench, trying to be ready to play each and every week.
And he'll go down, shy of the 40 at the 41. Well, the Giants will stop play as they take a timeout defensively. It's just their first, they'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And take another timeout. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and four.
Hey. Here we go. Blue 90. Blue 90.
This is going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we can spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line.
Giants offense now. They get ready to head back on the field. Very tough spot here for the offense to start. Second and 13. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. And they'll give it here to his running back. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. That'll set him back with a loss of three on the play. And that is going to set up third and goal. And now the question everyone's wondering, look at the clock, late fourth quarter, do they put the ball in the air here on third?
I don't. I run the football until my offensive line, no leakage up front. I want my running back hit as I hand the ball off to him. I don't want any type of an issue. But if I am going to throw it, quick throw out to the perimeter, maybe one of my best receivers running a quick slant or something like that. This drive started with first and goal. Now that it's fourth and goal, anything less than a touchdown would feel like a letdown to me.
And Hopkins' kick is good.
Take it from there.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Here we go now. Clifford!
He's trying to start this drive in the air. He's going to run fly. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. Fair to say, the secondary play, whichever side you're on, hasn't really been a glowing exhibition so far, but a nice job there to prevent a long completion.
I agree with you, but at some point, someone had to make a play and try to stop this exhibition of almost speed racing that we've been watching, huh?
Yeah, it has been quarterback and receiver dominated.
Let's go! 319! 319! Gone! 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 All right, now, look at 56.
They'll drop the throw. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. So now he's equaled his interception total from a week ago. Remember, Charles, he had three last week.
And you know, all week long, he vowed to take that number down. Told the guys on the team, don't worry, things are going to pick up. I've got this. But he is in a major league rut right now. Let's see if his teammates can pick him up along the way.
You're right. He talked about being cool, calm, collective, rebounding. Not rebounding right here. Be the last play and wrap things up. And Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. What are they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for Washington, their good start continues as they get their record up to 4-2. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the Pittsburgh Steelers come to town. Meanwhile, for the Giants, the loss will drop them to 4-2 on the year. And now they'll head to the bye week as he'll be back in action in Week 8. So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. It's a win for the Redskins as we say so long from FedEx.